Hello friends, I'm Preeti Hegde. Through today's topic of discussion, let's try to get basic layman's understanding about Indian Civil Service. Indian Civil Service has a history of more than centuries. Right from ancient period through medieval times, the rulers and kings had their own systems of administrative machinery and they were recruiting men to run it. But it was only during the British era that the more formalized, competition examination-based, cadre-based system of civil services was introduced, and the same legacy was continued even post-independence. So why civil services is considered so prestigious, coveted and valued? Even the Iron Man of India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, had called civil services as steel framework of India, which had to play a very vital role in the unification of India into a nation. The elected representatives and ministers will make laws and policies. It is the civil servants and bureaucrats who will put these policies and laws into action on the ground through various central and state government agencies. Union Public Service Commission, that is UPSC, is the main body for civil service recruitment in India. State Public Service Commissions and Staff Selection Commission are the other bodies for civil service recruitments. Now let us try to deep delve into the examination, that is civil service examination, conducted by UPSC. This examination covers around 19 Group A services, including Indian Administrative Service, that is the most coveted IAS, Indian Police Service, Indian Foreign Service, Indian Revenue Service, Indian Audit and Account Service, and so on, and 5 Group B services related to Union Territories. This civil service examination is conducted in 3 tiers. One is preliminary, second one will be main examination, third one will be personality test. This examination tries to assess the overall academic, logical, analytical abilities of a candidate as well as people skills of the candidate. The exam is conducted every year and the aspirants should be keen to look for notification because the dates are subject to change. Let us look into the scheme of examination in detail now. The first phase is preliminary examination phase that consists of 2 papers, both objective type, 200 marks each. This will try to assess the general understanding of the candidates both on conventional subjects as well as current events. So this is also called as civil service aptitude test. The qualified candidates from this phase will be allowed to write main examination, that is second stage. There, the candidate has to appear for 9 papers, 250 marks each. First 2 will be language papers, 1 English paper, and the second one will be on the Indian language chosen by the candidate. These 2 papers will be of qualifying nature. The third paper will be essay paper. Candidate has to write essays on topics of national and international relevance. Next will be general studies paper, 4 in number. The broad understanding of candidate related to history, geography, Indian economy, Indian polity, ecology, environment, ethics, aptitude, emotional intelligence, kind of various subjects will be assessed in this general studies papers. Last 2 will be 2 papers related to the optional subject chosen by the candidate. The qualified candidates from the main examination phase will be called for a personality test, which will be a face-to-face interview. The combined scores from main examination and the personality test will be considered to select the final list of candidates based on the vacancies available in the given year. Hope this information was useful. Please do like, comment, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching our video. All the best to all the aspirants who are looking to become civil servants.